या
द
ऑल ऑफ यू हैव
एफेयर
कॉल्ड और दिस व्हाट से द क्वेश्चंस आई गेव फॉर रिवीजन ऑल ऑफ यू हैव डन दैट.
मैम आई हैव डन द एमसीक्यूज इन आंसर द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 क्लासिफाई द फॉलोइंग चेंजेस सो मैम फ्रॉम व्हाट वी नीड टू क्लासिफाई आई डिड नॉट अंडरस्टैंड लाइक
Is
बिफोर
it a physical change or chemical change? Okay.
या दैट यू हैव नॉट मेंशन दैट व्हाई आई वाज कंफ्यूज्ड
Or it can be reversible. So you can write both. When it is not mentioned, na, so you can write physical and reversible, chemical and irreversible. Write that also. You can write some physical
Yes.
changes are irreversible also. Okay.
And ma'am, I did not understand
One of
that.
you will have to share the screen and then we can discuss. Okay. Who will share the screen?
Ma'am, you can't share. Ma'am, wait, I'm
Come, can
sharing.
I?
Just a
Ma'am,
moment.
I shared my screen. Can you see?
Yeah, Ibrahim, share the screen.
I have shared the screen, ma'am.
Ibrahim, you shared whiteboard.
Yeah, so ma'am only told to share whiteboard. Ma'am, in the science, all the science question, can we discuss it?
We'll discuss all the science questions, but this one I don't want you to share. That one, the questions which I have given on Google Classroom,
Ma'am,
I don't
should I
have
share?
that
Ma'am, should I
Yeah,
share?
you share.
Who is this polite cat? Please write your names and switch on your cameras, everyone.
Ma'am, can you see?
Yes. No, but... Okay, someone else. No, we cannot see like that, Yaya. We cannot see like that. Someone has got laptop or PC or so.
Ma'am, should I share?
Yes,
yeah,
Munib bhai, you share.
We need full screen, huh? This is coming like a mobile screen, so.
Ma'am, he can zoom.
Ma'am, the you want the science or na revision yeah, FA question bank? You want?
Yeah.
I have to share that one, no?
Yeah, that
yes.
one. Muhammad Muhammadi, switch on your camera. Rashta, Muneev.
Ma'am, 1 minute.
Ma'am, can you see?
Yes,
ma'am,
I can.
Want to say something? Ma'am, I am telling that can we discuss the question answers, not the multiple choice questions?
Because multiple
some
choice...
of you are facing difficulty in multiple choice questions also. So that is why I want to discuss this also. Okay?
Ma'am, I had difficulty in question answers, only a few of them.
Yeah, so those who have difficulty in question answers, we can have that. We can have a first MCQ. Which of the following fuel is used for running automobiles? What is the answer?
C and B, both it's both A and B. Option C.
Yes, option C. Chemical processes in which substance reacts with oxygen. What are others doing? Not giving answers. Substance, combustible substance are also known as
flaming.
No. Sorry,
yes, ma'am.
It is inflammable. Inflammable.
Yes, inflammable.
Answer is inflammable. Correct your answers. Those who have written flaming, okay. Understood? Please correct your answers. Which
yes,
of the
ma'am.
Following is a combustible? Which
wood.
Of the following is a combustible?
Wood, ma'am. Wood.
Wood. Wood.
Yes, wood is combustible. In the sun, light and heat are produced by
nuclear reaction.
Nuclear reaction.
First temperature at which a substance catches fire is also known as
ignition temperature.
Ignition temperature.
Substance. Now just scroll. Yeah. There is a question.
Ma'am, question number 8, ma'am.
substance which has very low ignition temperature and can catch fire easily.
Inflammable substances.
Inflammable substances.
It is actually, the answer should be all of these, okay? Because inflammable, flammable, same thing, combustible also catches fire easily, okay?
So but you can say combustible has low, ma'am. It is it's very low.
No, it can catch fire, okay? Inflammable
substances. Ma'am, but some combustible, substances have high.
But you can say that combustible substance can also have low ignition temperature. So you can have this also as answer. So option will be D in this case, okay? In this question, option will be D. Anas, have you opened your worksheet? If you have not done, please.
It is the form of LPG.
This is also very
liquid petroleum gas.
Liquefied petroleum.
Petroleum gas.
And ma'am, CNG.
Question: compressed natural gas. Okay, so okay, full forms also you should know. Liquefied petroleum gas, compressed natural gas. This can also be asked in the question exam. Which of the following are, okay, where is it the question?
I'm question number 10.
Which of the following are required essentially for producing fire?
Option D, fuel, air and heat.
D, fuel, air and heat.
Yes, ma'am.
The most common element.
Ma'am, CO2.
Carbon dioxide. Sodium
bicarbonate.
Which of the following is a physical change?
Melting of wax.
Which of the following is a chemical change?
Cooking of vegetables.
Yes. A chemical change may involve just
option D, all of the above.
Change in color only.
Right. No, option D, all of the above.
Achha, ma'am, D.
Which question we are doing? Which question?
Ma'am, we are doing 11. No, we are doing which one? 16. We are doing 16. 16, ma'am. It's all of these.
Yeah. A chemical change may involve what?
Ma'am, yes. All of the above.
All of the above.
I have given you definition of chemical change. Go through it. All the lesson, all the notes, or liquid fuel, solid fuel, what is combustion, everything you should know. Okay. What is chemical change? It accompanies 5-6 point is there. Evolution of gas, formation of precipitate, all those things, energy release, energy absorb, everything is there. The points are given to you. Which of the following are true when milk changes into curd? Go through the question and tell me the option.
First, third and fourth, ma'am. Option C, first, third and fourth. Option C, ma'am.
First, third and fourth.
Option C.
First, third and fourth, okay?
Yes.
A man painted his main gate made up of iron to prevent it from rusting, protect it from sun, make it look beautiful, make it dust free.
To prevent it from rusting.
No, you have to select the option A, B, C, D.
Ma'am. Option A. To prevent it from
rusting. A is 1 and 2. That means protect it from sun and protect it from rusting.
Ma'am, D. 1 and 3, ma'am.
Prevent it from rusting and make it look beautiful. Both options. So, D option is the correct answer. Okay? Clear? Next one. Which of the following statement is
incorrect for a chemical change? Heat may be given out but never absorbed.
Yes, ma'am. That
is the correct option. Because in chemical change, heat is absorbed also. Okay? So, that is the mistake over here. Sound is produced in chemical change. Color change is also there. Gas is also there. So incorrect is first option. Which of the following changes cannot be reversed?
Milk to paneer. Milk to paneer, ma'am.
Milk to paneer, right? Yeah.
Yes.
Last one.
Which one of the steps while burning a candle is not reversible? Option C, wax vapor burns into flame.
Wax vapor burns into flame.
Burning a candle is not reversible. Okay, which one of the steps while
wax
burning
vapor
a candle
burns into flame?
Yes, ma'am. Wax vapor.
Wax vapor burns into flame. Melting of solid wax. And what else?
No, ma'am. The answer will only be C1, ma'am.
Yes, answer is C. Wax vapors burns into flame. Okay, now moving on to the questions.
Yeah, ma'am, this is only difficult part.
A little bit more, come to the questions. Can we say that ironing off cloth is a reversible change? Give reason.
Yes.
Ma'am, can I say
the answer?
Okay, wait. Ibrahim and Yaya, just wait. I want answers from others also. Okay.
Ma'am, can we say
that ironing of cloth is a reversible change?
Yes, ma'am, it is a reversible change.
Give reason.
It is a reversible change because when we iron a cloth, there are ways it can go back to its original state, hence the reversible change. There are ways it can go back to its original state.
Yeah, Rashta, what is your answer?
It's reversible because it was not a chemical change.
No, it's not a chemical change, fine, but it can go back to its original. Amina's answer is correct because you can get it. It is not a chemical change, but it is not the reason that you will write here because you can get the original unironed cloth after ironing also. So that is why it is a reversible change. Okay?
And ma'am, after ironing, the molecules are not, ma'am, the molecules have not been changed or the
it's not a chemical change. That's what you're mentioning, molecules and all those things. It comes under chemical change only. Okay. What are differences between reversible and irreversible changes?
Ma'am, can I say this answer?
The answer those are written can only say because you can have 2-3 points. You know,
yes, ma'am, I have written.
Who else has written?
Yeah, he also has written, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Ibrahim, answer.
The differences between reversible and irreversible changes are, reversible changes can be undone, whereas irreversible changes cannot be undone. Ma'am, I told the first point.
Okay, who will tell the second point?
Ma'am, second point is example.
We always write... listen to me. Whenever difference is given, always write definition as the first point. Okay? Undone and done wala second point ho jayega. So tell me.
Ma'am, what is reversible.
Yes, Umaira.
Reversible change are temporary and irreversible change are permanent.
Yes, that is also next point. I want the definition as the first point. What is the definition I have given you,
ma'am,
for reversible?
Ma'am, can I say, ma'am?
Yes, Amina.
In irreversible change, a new substance is formed, and a reversible change, the same substance is reversed.
No, just go through the notes and
ma'am,
see
can
what
I say. Ma'am, can I say? Ma'am, can I say?
Yes. Yes,
in physical change, in reversible
ma'am.
Changes, there is no new substance is formed. Its molecules and its
flip and, through the pages and see what I have given you in notes. Just flip through the pages.
Ma'am,
ma'am, can I give the example, ma'am?
No, example. I want the definition.
ma'am, but ma'am, write examples na for 1 mark.
And the definition that you have given is reversible change is a change that can be reversed or undone. That's the definition that you have given.
Yes, that is the statement you have to write. Okay. Second point is temporary, permanent. 3 points. 3 points. Remember 3 points. First one is definition. Second point is reversible change is a temporary change and irreversible change is a permanent change.
And then example.
Example. Yes. Third point is example. So whenever difference is there, you will have the same happens with physical and chemical change also. Definition, temporary, permanent, you write. An example you write. Minimum 3 points should be there. Okay. Classify the following as reversible or irreversible changes. Now, growth of a plant. Is it
irreversible? It is an irreversible change.
Irreversible.
It is irreversible. Plowing a field?
Reversible change.
Okay. Melting of wax?
Reversible change.
Ma'am, reversible and irreversible. Both is there.
No. Melting of wax is reversible.
Okay. Yes, melting of wax is reversible.
Burning of wax is irreversible. Falling of rain.
Reversible change.
Reversible.
Yes. Falling of rain is reversible. Okay. Pulling of rubber string.
Reversible.
I'm reversible.
Breaking of glass rod.
Irreversible.
Yes. Cooking of food.
Irreversible.
Okay. Formation of cloud is a physical change. Explain. How will you explain?
And can I say? Let Yaya
say. Yes, you have to explain the water cycle.
Yes.
And Yaya wants to say. Ma'am, let Yaya.
Yes, you have to explain the water cycle. Okay. Okay. I'll just write out this answer. Okay. Or someone wants to tell. Yaya, yes, ma'am. You have to. Okay, speak then.
Of cloud is a physical change as it is transformed from water as liquid to gas during water cycle and then gas to liquid.
Yes, that is correct. Okay, just write down this answer. Write down this answer. I'm giving you the answer. Formation of cloud is a physical change. Written, clouds are formed by the condensation of.
You have given this question 2 times in the worksheet.
I have given you.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, can you say them again?
Ma'am, which
we wrote answer. Is that okay? I only wrote the answer once.
Just stop sharing, Muneet. Just stop sharing. I'll share my
screen. Yes, ma'am. One more time. Is cloud formation a physical or a chemical change? In this
sharing.
Only we knew that I'll
give you the answer in writing. Okay, write down this answer. Can you see?
Ma'am, in exam, we have to write this answer only.
Because it is written in proper words. Like, explanation is given. Clouds are formed by the condensation of water vapor present in the atmosphere. Okay? You know that how clouds are formed? Water vapor condensed to form cloud. When rainwater goes back on the earth, no new product is formed. Therefore, it is a physical change. Okay?
But same ma'am, I wrote that formation of cloud.
No, I wrote a longer answer than
formation of cloud is a physical change because water vaporizes and turns into.
You get 2 marks, may only 2 marks answer you will get. So this is like 2 marks may enough. Okay, Amina,
what happened? Same thing, but it's longer. I wrote that the formation of clouds is a physical change. It starts with evaporation when the seawater gets heated due to the sun. Water vapors are formed, and after a while. And after a while, the droplets that form from the water vapors get collected together to form clouds. When there are a lot of them, the rain starts to fall, forming seawater again. So this process is a physical change.
So, and then in the end, you just add, so no new product is formed. That is why it is a physical change. Okay.
Ma'am, can I say mine answer?
You wrote the same answer, na? That yeah, yeah.
No, ma'am. I wrote formation of cloud is a physical change because water vaporizes and turns into water vapors. These water vapors are cooled and then condensed to form clouds.
Yes. Then also, and these clouds, from these clouds, rainwater falls on earth. Okay. And no new product is formed. Okay. No new product is formed. Just add this line because that is ma'am, the
explanation from this of water, right, ma'am? From this.
Nah.
Water rain falls.
And from this water way. Falls as rain on the earth and no new product is formed. Okay. Done. Everyone
from
has
this
written.
Water rain
falls on earth as rain.
Ma'am, wait, I'm right.
And no new substance is formed, right, ma'am?
Right.
Man, I want to tell the eight questions answer.
What is the question?
Eight question answer means there is.
Ma'am, can we discuss the fifth question, ma'am? I did not understand that.
What is the fifth question? Read the fifth question.
Classify the following changes as I told you, ma'am.
Okay, before that, I'm just giving you one match the follow.
I didn't understand the ninth question.
Okay, coming to it. Should I erase it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Done,
ma'am. Work. I was busy.
Done?
Yes, ma'am. Done.
Let me erase it. Okay, what is the question now?
Ma'am, I share the screen.
Yeah, share the screen. Wait, I'll stop sharing it. Yeah. What is the question? Let us discuss the questions, then I'll give you my extra questions.
Ma'am, we did this one. Formation of clouds is a physical change.
Classify the following changes. Now, this again, is it a physical? Whenever nothing is written, so add it is a physical and reversible, chemical or irreversible, both you have to mention. Okay. Like breaking off a brick with a hammer. So it is a physical change, but irreversible. You can write like that, breaking off a brick with a hammer.
Yes.
Okay. So what is the next one?
And the answer is physical and irreversible.
Yes.
Breaking of heart. I'm beating off heart. Is
chemical change, but irreversible.
Beating of heart is irreversible, it is not physical also, it is irreversible change, and you can say it is a periodic change. Periodic means which repeats. Okay, so answer is beating of heart is a periodic change and irreversible. Where is the question gone? Yeah. Germination of a seed is irreversible change.
And a chemical change.
Chemical change.
No, chemical, it's not a chemical. We'll not write chemical, physical.
What is the answer of germination of a seed? It's physical.
Irreversible,
right?
Change. Irreversible. Burning of a seed.
And ma'am, no. it will be periodic, like breaking or beating of heart.
It will be a periodic change. Okay. Burning of an incense stick, again, it is a
chemical.
Irreversible and chemical.
And because irreversible. Chemical is
irreversible and chemical change, okay? Because chemicals are burning. Occurrence of a solar eclipse, it will be
irreversible and chemical change.
It happens every year.
Periodic and irreversible, okay?
Change and irreversible change.
We haven't learned about periodic yet, so even if you don't write periodic is fine. You can write irreversible is okay, fine. Now which question?
Germination of a seed is irreversible change, ma'am.
Yes, you cannot go back to the seed again, right? If the plant is grown, you cannot go back to the same seed.
But ma'am, okay? you can take the fruit and then.
But that is another, that will be another seed, not the same seed you are growing.
Okay. I had a doubt in question number 9. Is sodium something? Why is sodium kept immersed in kerosene?
Okay, I'll explain it. Sodium is very reactive, and when it comes in contact with air, it catches fire. Okay, it is so reactive. And its ignition temperature is so low that when it comes in contact with air, it catches fire. So that
ma'am,
is
can
why.
Can you write on whiteboard, ma'am? I also had a doubt in this.
Okay, stop sharing. I'll write it on the whiteboard.
And ma'am, write about the 11th one also. No.
Because ma'am, kerosene is a combustible substance.
Ma'am, write of 8th one also.
Let me give you this answer.
Ma'am, which question, ma'am?
What is the question number, Amina? Give the question number.
Nine.
Okay, this will be the answer. Why is sodium... is stored immersed in kerosene. Okay. So sodium has very low ignition temperature. So that is why it catches fire on coming in contact with air. So it cannot be kept in air open because it will catch fire. So it is kept
question number.
Question number 9. 9, Amina. Why is sodium immersed in? Yeah.
Ma'am, after temperature, what have you written, ma'am?
Is full form of that is. IE we write, in English you will learn, IE is a short form of that is. That is means it has low ignition temperature, or you can write therefore also. Therefore it catches, or that's why you can write.
Therefore is three dots in a triangle, right?
Right. Any other doubt? So that I'll write it here only then. Any other question? Difficulty?
Or ma'am, question number 8 and 10, I have doubt.
Question number 10, 8,
what does coal produce during its combustion?
It produces pollutants.
Pollutants, but define, what are the pollutants it produces?
Like acid gas.
Acid gas is there. Gas is there. Name the gas.
Gas which
is...
that burns the eyes. I'm done.
Coal produces which gas?
Pyroacid gas.
No, it is not called acid gas. Okay, I'm writing the other answer.
And ma'am, after this, write the eighth one also.
This is the answer. Coal produces which gas? Carbon dioxide and heat and light during its combustion. Okay. What does coal produce? So acid gas, you cannot say. Acidic gas also you cannot say. You have to say the gases are acidic. That is correct. But name of the gas, carbon dioxide. Okay.
What so question coal,
what question is it?
Question number 10.
Ma'am, okay. First I thought it was carbon dioxide, but then I told if something was wrong, so I asked the teacher. That's why I didn't
know. Whenever something burns, carbon dioxide is always produced. So coal produces carbon dioxide. When something burns, heat is also there and light is also there. They have asked what is produced. So what are the things produced when coal burns? It produces a gas, carbon dioxide, then heat and light during its combustion. Okay?
Remember when something burns, oxygen is produced and then carbon dioxide cuts the oxygen.
Ma'am, the eighth one also. There are three.
It's always produced because whenever anything burns, carbon dioxide is always produced. Okay? Oxygen is used.
Ma'am.
During combustion, you know that oxygen is used. Without oxygen, nothing can burn. And what is produced? Product is carbon dioxide. Okay.
Can you say the eighth one? I did not understand, ma'am.
Okay, what is the eighth question? Tell me.
Ma'am, the two methods of preventing.
There are three factors which support burning. Fire extinguisher affects which factor?
The three factors which support burning are air or oxygen, fuel, ignition temperature, or heat. Then, how to extinguish it? The fire extinguisher affects the air factor because in fire extinguisher there is carbon dioxide, and carbon dioxide is heavier than oxygen and stop the supply of oxygen, and the fire can be controlled.
Such a long answer you don't need. Answer is correct.
Ma'am, can you show the answer?
Fire extinguisher affects the air factor because it has carbon dioxide which cuts the supply of oxygen.
Correct. Supply of air or oxygen. So fire.
Ma'am, can you show the answer,
ma'am,
of this question? Eighth one.
Ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, if sodium has very low ignition temperature, then why is it kept in kerosene? Because if then kerosene is also a combustible substance, then
combustible substance. But its ignition temperature is not that low. Kerosene does not catch fire on its own. But sodium will catch fire on its own when it is in air. Because air, it needs only air. Temperature is so low that ignition temperature ki usko zarurat hi nahi hai. The ignition temperature is so low that when it comes with oxygen, it catches fire. Whereas kerosene ka ignition temperature is not that low. Okay. So when sodium is kept in kerosene, it is not in contact with air. Air ke saath contact mein nahi hai, and that is why it is not catching fire.
Ma'am, can you please show the eighth question? I did not understand. Eighth, ma'am. Eighth one. Can you
one by one ask question? Yes, Muhammad. What is your question?
Air cannot enter kerosene.
No. Air is not dissolved in kerosene. Okay. So oxygen is not there in kerosene. Oxygen is dissolved in water, but it is not in kerosene. So that is why you can say that. Okay. Then what did
you, ma'am? Question number 8, ma'am. Can you please show on whiteboard?
Repeated in question number 11.
No, which question? You just read the question. I don't understand.
Ma'am, there are three factors which support burning. Fire extinguisher affects which factor? So, ma'am, can you write the answer of that?
Okay.
Ma'am, so the three factors are the
air.
Factors, remember? Yeah.
Fuel, ma'am, air, fuel, and ignition temperature.
Air, fuel, and heat.
Yeah, so in heat only ignition temperature would come, right?
Yeah, to first order, we can also do heat.
Ma'am, I was telling that the 11th question is repeated. What are the three essential requirements for combustion?
Okay, so don't do it again. So fire extinguisher cuts off the supply of air. Okay.
So ma'am, this is only the answer we have to write. We don't have to write the
This is fire extinguisher. Okay. Now if I ask, okay, suppose a building catches fire and a fire brigade is called. Okay. So fire brigade affects which factor out of these three?
Ma'am, it will cut the amount
of heat. Ma'am, it will affect the heat because if they will use water, it will.
Yeah.
It
so will so fire brigade will do. Fire brigade lowers the ignition temperature because it puts water at high pressure, right? What does fire brigade do? Fire brigade puts water at high pressure. So putting water lowers the ignition temperature, right? You need ignition or cuts off the heat also, you can say.
Ma'am, this fire extinguisher cuts off the supply of air is the answer of question number 8.
Yeah, supply of air in bracket, you can write this thing also. In bracket, you can write oxygen after air.
Ma'am, so you will give 2 marks for this, ma'am.
Yeah,
ma'am, it is a very small answer, ma'am. It will be 1 mark.
It's 1 mark answer. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Why my name is coming? Okay, done the question. Now, which question is left? Tell me. Any other doubt? Anyone has any other difficulty? Okay, just open. Just share the slide, Muneeb, again.
Yes, ma'am. You have to unshare.
We need peanut butter. Ma'am, we will discuss all the question answers.
Some more questions I have, so I'll show you those questions.
Can you see?
Okay. Yes, we can see. Now, which questions are done? What does coal produce during combustion done? What are the 3 essential requirements for combustion?
M6,
you know
and,
the
point.
Yes, we did that.
So, you already know. If you see a person whose clothes are on fire, how will you extinguish the fire? So, you will wrap a blanket around the person because...
the supply of oxygen.
Correct. A blanket cuts off the supply of oxygen. Okay? Or air.
Roll.
So they have asked, what will you do? Give reason for the following. This we have already done. LPG is better domestic fuel than wood. Why? Give 2 points because at least.
It doesn't cost pollution.
Correct. Then? Using wood as fuel encourages deforestation.
Okay. Ma'am, which question, ma'am?
This one. LPG is better domestic fuel than wood.
Okay.
Yeah. Why LPG is better?
You gave it before also. Ma'am, you gave it before also.
Yeah, this was done in class also. So, we have done. How does pouring water extinguish the fire? By?
Ma'am, By
lowering the ignition temperature and cutting off the supply of heat. Okay. Lowering ignition temperature. Do you want me to write the answer? How does pouring water extinguish a fire? By lowering the ignition temperature and cutting the supply of heat. Okay. Explain.
Fire caused by electricity should not be extinguished
by pouring water. This also we have done. Why? Pouring water will
electrocution.
So you have to mention water is a good conductor of electricity.
The person who is trying to put out the fire will get electrocuted.
Explain why we are not advised to sleep in a room having closed doors and windows with a coal fire burning inside. Who will answer this?
It can cause suffocation.
Can I say?
It leads to suffocation.
The harmful smoke, it can cause suffocation.
Because the coal burning gives out carbon dioxide.
Carbon monoxide. You have to say carbon monoxide. Okay, I'll give you the answer. Stop sharing, Muneeb. Just stop sharing it.
Ma'am, but you made us write that coal produces carbon dioxide.
Yes, ma'am.
Carbon dioxide, okay. I'll explain you the reason.
Number 10, in question number 10 answer, you make us write that the coal produces carbon dioxide.
Just a moment, ये वाला को shift करने में. Okay, what happens in closed rooms, there is limited supply of air. Okay, so whenever coal burns in limited supply of air, it is called as incomplete combustion, and carbon monoxide is produced, which is a poisonous gas. Okay, in open when coal burns, it produces carbon dioxide. When coal burns in limited supply of oxygen, this is carbon in limited supply of oxygen. Okay, limited, you understand now, because
it is closed in a closed area.
Yeah, so this is in a closed room. In limited supply of oxygen, carbon monoxide is produced. Okay, so in limited supply of oxygen, carbon monoxide is produced, whereas when enough oxygen is there, carbon dioxide is produced. Always remember that. And carbon dioxide is a poisonous gas. It can lead to a person's death also. Okay, whereas carbon dioxide just pollutes, it will not lead to, means too much of carbon dioxide will lead to respiratory problems and all, but carbon dioxide leads to death. Okay,
carbon monoxide or carbon dioxide?
Carbon monoxide is poisonous, it leads to death, but carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, you know what is the formula of carbon monoxide? CO. Mono means one oxygen, dioxide means two oxygen. So carbon dioxide, CO2.
Carbon dioxide is green.
Green? No.
Okay.
You cannot see the color of carbon dioxide. But if you test carbon dioxide by, if you pass it through lime water, it will turn milky. Then it is carbon dioxide. Okay? Yeah. Yes, Abdullah.
Ma'am, so in the answer, we have to write this also in limited supply of oxygen.
Yeah, in closed room, here you put the bracket. In closed room, put the bracket, in limited supply of oxygen, carbon monoxide is produced, which is a poisonous gas. That is why the person feels suffocated in the room. And you can add it over here that it leads to, suffocation and ultimate death.
Which gas, that green gas, which gas is that green gas?
I don't remember. Might be
green chlorine gas effect.
Chlorine gas is green. I think so. I don't remember the color right now.
Ma'am, we put chlorine in swimming pools.
Nitrogen dioxide is chlorine gas I'm talking about. Nitrogen dioxide is brown in color. Okay, so this question is clear.
Ma'am, oxygen is what color?
I think it is colorless. Oxygen has no color. Oxygen, hydrogen, no color.
Ma'am, transparent, ma'am.
No color. Transparent color nahi hota hai. Transparent to see through.
That's why, ma'am, water does not have color, because it is made of H2O, that's hydrogen and oxygen.
Okay, now just share the question again so that we see what are the questions left.
Ma'am, what is fossil gene?
You can answer.
What is what?
Fossil gene.
Spelling? I don't understand. Fosogi, what is it?
P-H-O-S-G-E-N-E.
Phosphorus you are talking about?
Ma'am, can I say the answer of sixth one? We've not discussed that. Yes.
15, we have done. Why fire caused by electricity should not be extinguished pouring water, we have done. What chemical?
Ma'am, we didn't do is souring of milk is a physical or change or chemical change. Why?
Ma'am, can I say? Can I say?
That you can do. That you can do. Why chemicals? What chemicals can put out a fire? What chemicals can put out a fire?
Carbon dioxide.
Yeah, carbon dioxide is a gas. Okay, fine. And
sodium bicarbonate. Sodium bicarbonate.
Yes, sodium bicarbonate. You have to say. Why are fires produced by burning?
Yes, ma'am.
Sodium bicarbonate is same. Chemical name is baking.
Ma'am, we can write baking soda also, right? In the paper, or we need to write sodium bicarbonate.
Better to write sodium bicarbonate. You should know the chemical name of baking soda also. Okay. Why are fires produced by burning oil, not extinguished
ma'am,
by
ma'am, baking soda is a chemical, but we put it in food, ma'am.
Huh, it is fine. Salt is also a chemical, NaCl. We put in every cooking item.
Ma'am, I know the answer. Can I say?
Okay, tell me this answer. Kaha gaya question? This one, na? No, which one? Why are fires produced by burning oil, not extinguished
in glass only?
Because water floats on oil and will not extinguish it.
Yeah. Why? Water does not float on oil. Oil floats on water. Who will say?
If we put water in oil, so the oil is lighter than water, so it will come up.
Correct. Oil is lighter. Yes, correct.
Sorry.
Ma'am,
you only said it was lighter.
Uh-huh. Oil is lighter. I was talking water is heavier.
Come up and it will spill out and then it will go here and there. So the fire will be also caused more, ma'am.
Yeah, fire will spread more. Correct answer. So you have to mention water is heavier. So water falls, water, the oil is on the top and the fire spreads more, whereas water does not help in lowering the temperature also, because the temperature is so high during the fire, oil fire, the temperature is so high that the water changes into water vapor and the oil, the fire oil does not get controlled. I think I have given you this answer also. If you want, I can give you again.
Ma'am.
Yeah.
Inflammable substance on which fire is not burn, right? Like on which fire does not burn.
Inflammable means which can burn easily. Okay. Just stop sharing. I'll give you this answer. This answer I'm giving you. Why? What was the question? Burning oil is not extinguished by pouring water. Just stop sharing and give the answer for this.
Yes, question ma'am. Number. I have given this answer in that Saurav's question. Saurav's mother and that you gave no.
This that there also na. Okay. Still again, I am giving you those who have not got this answer. Water cannot put off fire produced due to burning petrol or kerosene. Because water is heavier than oil, this is the important point. It settles down or sinks below the oil particles and cannot bring the ignition temperature of the substance down or cannot cut off the supply of air to the fire. So oil keeps on burning on the top. Okay?
Ma'am, this is which question number answer, ma'am?
This is like why?
18, ma'am.
18.
This is question number 18. Okay.
18 question. Okay. Why fire due to oil cannot be controlled using water? Okay. This is the question. So this is the answer for that. This is the last answer. Rest of the questions and some more questions we'll discuss in the next class. Okay. I think the time is over. So some fill in the blanks and some more new questions I'll give you in the next class.
Ma'am?
Yes?
I wrote this answer. Because oil is heavier than water and it floats on top of water.
There is a correction. Oil is lighter than water. Water is heavier than oil. Okay?
Sorry, ma'am.
Yeah, yes. Just correct it. Yeah, then?
Because oil is lighter than water and it floats on top of water.
Yes.
And it floats. We pour water on left caused by air. It will not extinguish. It will promote the fire.
Correct. That is also correct. Main important point is water is heavier. Yeah, oil is lighter. And it... So the oil, the fire on the oil floats, as oil floats on the surface, the fire spreads, and water also does not lower the ignition temperature. That one point also you include, because water ka purpose hai to lower the ignition temperature, but here the temperature is so high that it cannot bring down the ignition temperature also. Done. Time is over. So should I stop sharing now?
No.
Everyone has written.
Yes, ma'am. I'm done.
Okay, those who have completed can go.
Completed.
Okay.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye. Let me know when you complete it. Huh?
Ma'am, done. Can I leave?
Yes, yes. Who is writing? Abdullah and Muni?
James, oil keeps on burning.
Yes, ma'am. I'm on the last line only.
Okay.
Ma'am, done.
Okay, bye.
Done, ma'am.
Okay, then I'm stopping it. Okay, bye. See you in the next class. Rest questions in the next.
Hence on burning the, what was it? Hence oil keeps on burning the.
Burning on top. The top.
On the top. Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.